So I'm just gonna come out and say it. Nest kind of sucks when it comes to power problems, but I'm pretty stubborn guy and I have to come up with solutions for these kinds of things. Otherwise I can't sleep at night. I don't know why, but what I'm gonna share with you guys today is a solution I came up with for if you lack a common wire, you have multiple zones, so your transformer is pretty much tapped out of power. And on top of all that, you might have compatibility issues between an S thermostat and some systems. So what I'm gonna show you guys today is how to use a transformer, a rib relay like this, and a power connector to overcome all these problems all at once and to make everything work. That said, if you have a first or second generation Nest learning thermostat, this isn't gonna work for you because lo and behold, Nest's own product is not compatible with those thermostats. So great, thank you, Nest. All I can suggest, call Jesus because you all need a miracle. But with the rest of us, let's jump into it. All right, so what we have here is everything we're gonna need to make this all work. We have two transformers here. This is your original transformer that is powering your zone valves. It's running up to all your old thermostats. And what we have is another transformer here that we're gonna install. And this is gonna be our dedicated transformer for all our Nest thermostats. So when you wire this in, you wanna make sure, ideally if you have a transformer box like this after your burner shutoff switch, you wanna wire that out of the same box. You wanna make sure you wire these things in after the burner shutoff switch. So once you have that transformer in, you're gonna need a relay and a power connector for each one of the Nest thermostats you're going to install. You're going to need maybe a little bit of wiring. A three-wire thermostat would work fine. And I'm going to show you how to hook all of this up to either a Honeywell or a Taco zone valve. So to begin, what we're going to do is we're going to find the two thermostat wires that are coming from our first installed Nest thermostat. And we're going to find those wires where they are down by the zone valve. Now it's going to be a red and white wire. And what you're probably going to find is the red wire from the original load on the transformer is going to go up to all the red wires on all your old thermostats. So there's going to be a bundle of red wires there that you're going to disconnect your new thermostat wire from. White wire coming back from your thermostat, that's either going to go to one of the yellow wires on your Honeywell zone valve. It may be going to the number one terminal on a Taco zone valve. But we're going to disconnect that as well. We're going to go ahead and we're going to wire in RH and W1 or R and W on our Nest thermostat to the wires coming out of the wall. We're going to find the thermostat wires going to the base of our new Nest thermostat. We're going to find the other end of those wires down by our zone valve somewhere. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to disconnect those two wires from wherever they're hooked up. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our power connector and we're going to hook the red up to the gray R wire here, and we're going to hook our white wire from our thermostat up to the gray W wire. So what we have here is our red and white wires from our thermostat hooked directly up to R and W wires on our Nest power connector, the gray wires here. So now we got these three wires here. What we're going to do is we're going to take a little bit of thermostat wire and we are going to run it off of our transformer that's going to be powering our thermostats. So what we're going to do is we're going to hook a red wire up to the load side of our new transformer. We're going to hook the white up to the common side of the transformer. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take this red wire off of the transformer's 24 volt load. And we're going to hook that directly up to the R wire on our Nest power connector. This is going to be the white R wire on the right side of the power connector. Now what we have left is our common wire and W wire and the common from the transformer. So on these relays, you have a blue and white, a black and white, and a yellow and white. The black and white is for 120 volt source or a load, and we're not going to be using that. So we're just going to take a wire nut and we're just going to cap that wire right off. So what we're going to be using is the blue and white and yellow white. We're going to take the blue and white and we're going to hook that up to the W on our, the white W wire on our Nest power connector. Then we are going to take the yellow and white. This is going to be the common after the 24 volts goes through the relay. And we're going to hook that up to the common on the power connector and the common on the transformer wire. We have our power coming off our transformer. It is going to go directly into the white R wire on our Nest power connector. The power connector is going to send that power onto the gray R wire on the power connector, and it's going to send it up to the R terminal on our thermostat. The thermostat calls for heat. It's going to send that 24 volts on the W1 terminal down the white wire. That white wire is going to come down into the gray W wire on your power connector. It's going to go into your power connector. It's going to come back out the white W wire on the power connector, and that 24 volts is then going to go through your relay and back out the yellow and white wire as the common, where it's going to hook up to the common on the Nest power connector and the common on the transformer, and that's going to complete the circuit. So on the other side of this relay, we have solid covers. We have orange, yellow, and blue. We're going to be using the orange and yellow. So our orange wire is the normally open wire on our system. Normally open means the circuit's going to be open until this relay is energized, and then it's going to close the circuit and power our zone valves. So we are not going to be using the blue wire, so we will also cap that off and push it aside. We are going to take the original power from our original power source on a transformer, and we are going to hook that up to the orange wire on our relay. So in this circumstance, this transformer is always going to be sending power up to that orange wire, and when the relay closes on a call for heat, it is going to continue sending that 24 volts on our yellow wire. Now on a Honeywell zone valve, that yellow wire is going to connect to one of the yellow wires on the zone valve. On a Taco three-wire zone valve, that yellow wire is going to get connected directly to terminal one. And that would be it for your Taco zone valve system. You're completely done. This common wire should already be hooked up to a bunch of other commons. That's it. You're done with Taco. The Honeywell, I'm going to hook up yellow to yellow. And I'm going to take the other yellow on the zone valve and hook that up to the common going back to the transformer. So your boiler circuit, the TNT circuit, regardless of where it's coming from, whether it's an aquastat, the boiler itself, it doesn't matter because you're not touching any of that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and hook my multimeter up to these two red wires. That's our TNT connection. That is what's going to fire the boiler up once all this works. But I don't have a boiler here, so I'm just going to hook my multimeter up to it, and we will get continuity on that when everything is fired up. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to test the thermostat. And I suggest you guys do this after each thermostat you install, just to make sure that not only does it work, but there are a lot of people ask the question on how many Nest thermostats can you run off of one transformer. And there really is no straightforward answer to it because there's a lot of variables involved. When you get this whole setup wired up, you want to go ahead and turn your power back on. Test it out, make sure everything works, and then as you install another thermostat, you want to do the same thing. You want to test it, make sure it works before you move on to the next one. By doing it one at a time, you will eventually get to a point, if you're wiring in five of these Nest thermostats, you might get to thermostat number four and discover power problems, which means your transformer is pretty much topped out and you're going to have to add an additional transformer once again to continue on from that point. So what I'm going to do now is I have everything powered up here. I have the burner switch on. The thermostat is working. I'm going to call for heat, and when it calls for heat, it's going to activate this relay. The relay is going to go ahead and operate the zone valve, and you could maybe see the motor moving there. And then we're going to have continuity on our multimeter, which tells us the TNT circuit is activated, the boiler will fire up, and everything's working great. So I'm going to shut this down once again, and the same thing will happen in reverse. Our relay will deactivate, the zone valve will unpower, open up the motor, lost continuity, boiler shuts down. So once you've tested the first thermostat, everything's working fine, you're going to go ahead and you're going to move on to the next thermostat. So what you're going to do is you're going to take a short piece of thermostat wire, you're going to take the red wire and hook it up to the same connection we made here with the load off our transformer and the white R wire off our power connector. So we're tapping off the same power source off of that red wire there, and we're going to do the same thing with the white wire. We're going to hook up to the common where that hooks up off of the transformer. So now you have an extension of the 24 volts in the common off the transformer that you can work with on the next thermostat. And then once you're finished wiring that thermostat, you take another jumper and work from that point onto the next thermostat. So you're kind of doing a chain down the road so that you don't have to wire all these things, all these Nest power connectors and relays all up in one spot. You can kind of space them out and put them up nicely and all that. And that's it.